Wow, these impeachment hearings are really something, aren't they? One could even say they're unprecedented. Precedented. Get it?
Yeah. Ugh.
It has been another wild week in the impeachment inquiry. They all are wild these days. So I'm going to start with the top five headlines from the week that was in 30 seconds or less. Go. Number one, hearings moved to the House Judiciary Committee where four constitutional scholars testified. Number two, Nancy Pelosi has called for articles of impeachment against Trump, saying she has, quote, no choice but to act. Number three, Trump responded to the unfolding events via Twitter, tweeting, quote, we will win. Number four, the White House responded saying it is very ready for a Senate trial if articles are drafted. And number five, in the midst of all of this, Giuliani has traveled to Ukraine to talk with former Ukrainian prosecutors for a documentary series. Whew. Now, we've been covering the impeachment for what feels like forever now, though it's really honestly only been a few months, and a lot of you have been asking me, what's up with these subpoenas? Now, many members of the Trump administration have been subpoenaed to testify in the impeachment hearings against the president and have not obliged, which is, well, technically illegal. To help us sort this out, I'm joined by my friend, CNN legal analyst, and maybe future Jeopardy host, Laura Coates. Laura's legal experience is through the roof. She served as a trial attorney in the Civil Rights Division, the Department of Justice during the Bush and Obama administrations, and she has been the Assistant United States Attorney for the District of Columbia. Laura also hosts the eponymous Laura Coates Show on SiriusXM and has worked as an adjunct professor at the George Washington University School of Law. On top of all this, yes, that Jeopardy reference wasn't random, Alex Trebek said he hoped Laura might one day host Jeopardy. Wow! Anyone else feeling extremely unaccomplished? Okay, Laura, I want to start basic.
Okay.
Congressional subpoena versus subpoena in a legal criminal setting. Different? The same? What's different? What's the same?
Well, they weren't supposed to be. I mean, a subpoena is a document that you give to somebody and you say, this is not optional. You can't just say, I don't feel like attending your little ceremony slash hearing slash litigation court proceeding. It's supposed to be intended to say you are compelled to not only testify and appear, but you actually have to bring with you what I've asked for. That's part of it. It's kind of a holistic, comprehensive, you're not just phoning it in.
Are we treating this as historically anomalous, even though it's not just because it's Trump? Like, in the past, have we seen this sort of thing happen? And members of the administration are subpoenaed, they choose not to honor or comply with said subpoena, and nothing really happens.
We absolutely have seen prior administrations essentially stonewalling. Mm-hmm. And it's a little bit disingenuous to say that nothing was ever done, but it happened in successive administrations. Remember with an Eric Holder. Remember actually with the Obama administration, with the George W. Bush administrations, the stonewalling was dealt with courts, and then a later president had to put the person in. They had to then give over documents. So it was a more of a delayed
So it was just a longer,
long process,
right.
Which is probably what informed this Congress to say it's going to take some time. Having said that, remember, Nixon and some of the articles of his impeachment did have to do with him not wanting to comply with congressional demands.
Right.
And so this is not truly novel, but you're right in saying that Congress in this era of Trump has been grappling with so many first-time novel things that this seems to fit a pattern, even though it's not.
And it's a reminder, I think, and you can speak to this more, but I'm always reminded of it, like the political calendar and timeline of impeachment, let's say, and then the legal system, these are not in the legal system, people say politics moves so late. The legal system, right, it's just on a different pace.
It's like a sloth's pace. You think about the bureaucratic, first of all, it's kind of ironic to think about that everyone is angry that Congress is moving too quickly. Let's just put that in your mind.
It's like
the
last thing Congress gets crazy. They're doing too much.
You're doing too fast. Could you slow down, add more red tape? That might make more sense.
Okay, I want to end on this. Mulvaney, Giuliani, let's throw Bolton in there, though, as we've noted, hasn't been subpoenaed. Do we hear from any of these people in front of Congress? I know I'm asking you to look into the future, but what's your expert opinion on, or do we never wind up hearing from them on what they knew vis-a-vis Ukraine?
It's important to think about what stage we're in. Remember, when the articles of impeachment are being drafted or even contemplated, you're talking about a threshold of what your immediate burden of proof may be. Like, what do I need to actually charge someone
in order
with
to
a
make this
crime?
Happen. Right.
This is not the trial stage. The trial is when you would have, say we were in a court of law, you would have the other witnesses coming forward. There may be a more fulsome record. The defense wants to put some things on, in this case, President Trump and his team. So it may well be that they will be part of the trial phase, although they didn't have to be there to actually create the charging documents.
And when you say the trial phase, you mean the Senate trial. Okay,
Senate
so
trial
that's the right way to understand
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I mean, you think
this
about...
This is kind of the investigation stage in the House and then the trial phase in the Senate. Is that fair? I mean,
yes.
I know it's a rough comparison to
well,
legal.
Well, it's a good comparison to make because you think about articles of impeachment like an indictment, that's the charging document that essentially says, okay, you're on notice now of what we think you did wrong. But if you are somebody like a president of the United States, this is the time you have to throw caution to the wind. You're on trial for your presidency. Although the funny thing is, he could very well be impeached, convicted, and removed, and still be on the November ballot.
That's right. Good times. What a prospect. Lauren Coates, thank you.
Thank you.
So what's my big takeaway from all that subpoena talk with Laura? Well, honestly, the thing I found most helpful was that you can think of the current impeachment process in Congress sort of like a legal investigation. The House piece that we're seeing now is the investigatory part and the charging part. The trial in the Senate is just like a regular trial in a legal proceeding where both sides get to make their cases and call witnesses, and then the jury, in this case the Senate, gets to make up their mind. We all love law and order, and so maybe that metaphor helps you. It certainly helped me. Got a question, an idea for an impeachment segment we should do? I'd love to hear them. You can put them all, I believe it's down there in the comments section. Make sure also to check out all of the Point content we put on YouTube. That's every Tuesday, Thursday, and special impeachment episodes like this one every weekend.